Okay, good day everyone. So we'll continue the discussion of our subject CDI 6, the fire protection and arson investigation. So we are now on part 2. So we'll be discussing the basic fire investigation. So the preliminary notes. So this is the as a general, this is the work of the Bureau of Fire and Protection. Okay, so in the Philippines, the Bureau of Fire Protection is the main government agency responsible for the prevention and suppression of all destructive fires, including the buildings, houses, and other structures, even to the forest, land transportation vehicles and equipments, ship or vessels docked at the pier or major seaport, petroleum industry installation, plane crashes and other similar incident, as well as the enforcement of the fire code and other related laws. It has the major power to investigate all causes of fire and necessary file the proper complaint with the proper authority that has jurisdiction over the case under the Republic Act number 6975. Okay, so the Republic Act 6975, this is also known as the ILG Act of 1990, wala ko na sipyat. Okay, so the Republic Act 6975, there are three bureaus under this law: the Philippine National Police, the BGMP, the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, and the lastly, the Bureau of Fire Protection, the BEP. Okay, so ang BEP is, they are their work or their primary function is to prevent and suppress all kinds of destructive fires, including all the buildings. As long as may kalambigitan lang nasa kalayo, nasunog ang building, trabaho na sa Bureau of Fire and Protection. Okay, so the Bureau of Fire and Protection was created by virtue of the Republic Act 6975, primarily to perform the following function. So their function under the Republic Act 6975 is to be the responsible for the prevention and suppression of all destructive fires, including the buildings, houses, and other structures. Forest also, land transportation vehicle and equipment, ship or vessel docked at piers or anchored in a major seaports, and also the petroleum industry installation. If ever may magka-abiriya dia or nasunog na ang industry, the fire will be the primary agency to called upon in prevention of that specific problem, especially na sa petrol industry. We have also the land transportation vehicles and equipment, and also the plane crash. So automatic na agi na Bureau of Fire dia, basta na emergency landing, so automatic agad-agad mayroong fire truck dia. Other similar incident. So the Bureau of Fire Protection was created by virtue of Republic 6975 primarily to perform the following function. So ikaduha, be responsible for the enforcement of Fire Code of the Philippines, the Presidential Decree number 1185 or the Republic Act 9514 and other related laws. So muna ni bag-o karon nga balaod. Shall have the power to investigate all causes of fire and if necessary, file a proper complaint with the city or provincial prosecutor was jurisdiction over the case. In times of national emergency, all elements of BEP shall upon direction of the president assist the armed forces of the Philippines in meeting the national emergency. Shall establish at least one fire station with adequate personnel, firefighting facilities, and other equipment in every provincial capital, city and municipal, subject to the standard rules or regulation as may be promulgated by the DLG. That's why in every municipality or city, there would one fire station. So sa Lalana, tayo fire station, sa Patagan, sa Baroy, sa Tubod. So ginana mandated na sa RA 6975. Okay, that's the legal mandate. Next, the vision. A world-class fire protection. World-class fire meaning to say, pang world-class ang ato ang mga Bureau of Fire diri in terms of fire protection. So we have the World-Class Fire Protection Agency working toward a public safety conscious society. Okay, this is the vision of the Bureau of Fire and Protection. Timanin nyo, a World-Class Fire Protection Agency working toward a public safety conscious society. So if that is the vision, mo po ni mission sa BP to prevent and suppress destructive fires, enforce fire-related laws, and provide emergency medical and rescue services. So diba, Bureau of Fire Protection is not only for the suppression of destructive fires, but also perform other related laws, provide emergency and medical and rescue services. Kana may na-trap sa building, na yung mga baha. So ilaha po ng trabaho, dili lang sa fire. BP programs and other services. So fire prevention. So under sa fire prevention, na adra ang fire safety information campaign, most especially during sa March, kay mo na yung murag ting sunog nga panahon, kay init kaayo. So paspasan nila na ang gitawag og fire safety information campaign, nga unsay buhaton kung magsunog, unsay buhaton para ma-prevent ang sunog, ana ba? Then we have also the fire safety inspection. That's why in every building today, there would be a fire safety inspection conducted by the personnel of the Bureau of Fire and Protection. So to ensure also that the building is accessible during sa pag-responde, na example na, i-check nila nang naabay fire extinguisher, i-check nila nang naabay mga fire exit, trabaho na nila. Unsay mga security measures nga naa diha, kung duha ka building na siya, unsay mga kuan, inspeksyonon po ng mga wire. Tanan-tanan, trabaho na sa Bureau of Fire. Next, we have also the fire suppression, fire fighting and control. When we see fire suppression, there is already a fire happen. So ilang gina fire suppress. So example, mo respond sila kung naisunog nga balay. So that's what called under na sa fire fighting and control. Fire investigation. So since hindi ginamalik kaya na ay mahitabo nga sunog, so there would investigation conducted. What the causes and the origin of fire. So mana siya. And if possible, that there would be filing of case in the prosecutor's office if na ay may tabong intentional. Next, BAP program and other services. Number 3, emergency medical and rescue services. So dili lang sa fire sila nakapokus sa sunog, kundi naapos na yung mga emergency medical. They will be conducting the medical and dental services. Mangibot po na sila ngipon, putupi, ano ba? Search and rescue services. Kanang na yung mga natrap sa mga baha, natrap sa buntod, trabaho po na sa mga Bureau of Fire and Protection. Special program and projects. So we have a fire safety education drive. So mag-conduct na sila mga symposium. KD and junior fire marshal. So magkuhan sila na, ma-organize sila ng grupo and other operation. So, we have the Bureau of Fire Protection National Headquarters Organization Structure. So, pinakataas nilang position is the fire chief. So, with the rank of kanang gitawag na nagrang, ang rank nila kay 2-star. Di, sana na siya karon gani. Chief Superintendent, daily. Major superintendent. Okay, BEP ano dili major superintendent, major general ang pinakataas nila nga rank. Okay, so next, the fire chief is assisted by this kanang sa admin and operation. Okay. So, sa administrative class is naada internal audit services, senior executive assistant, personnel aid office. Under po sa operation, naada ang public info services, internal affairs services, kaning IAS, legal services, and chaplain offices. So, we have also the chief for directorial staff. So directorial staff na adara ang Directorate for Administration, Directorate for Controllership, Directorate for Plan and Standard Development, Directorate for the Fire Safety and Prevention Directorate for the Logistic, yung mga supply, Directorate for the Operation. So sa operation, under niya Operation and Operation Division, Health Emergency Management Division, Special Operation Division, so on and so forth. So next, fire safety plan. So the fire safety plan is a very important part of the overall fire and life safety program with the building. So its purpose is to prevent potential injuries and death and protect your residential or other company from damage or loss. So on sa fire safety plan, so this is the overall fire and life safety program with the building. Okay. That's why if na building ito, kung pangitaan yun na fire safety plan. So, muna siya. So, ang purpose ana niya is para ma-prevent potential injuries. That's why pangitaan sa taga-bureau fire, naabay fire exit, naabay mga fire extinguisher. So, naabay ka tong mga, kanang mga kana aksa, dapay ka nang sa water sprinkler, depende kung mga dagko na nga mga building. Itaan nila na og katong sa tubo. Naa silay ka nang si tawag ani niya ay fire hydrant kumbaga, ana ba? Next, what fire should be why fire should be investigated? So nganang imbestigaran man ang fire? So the answer is simple. The fire should be investigated to determine the cause of fire. So, investigaran siya para ma-determine ang unsay hinungdan sa sunog in order also to prevent the similar occurrences. Okay? So, there are three causes of fire. Tomorrow, ganyan tulog ka klase ng causes of fire. Imanin ninyo ha. Number one is what? Okay, natay gitawag o natural cause sa fire. So, since why we need to investigate fire in order to determine the cause of fire? So there are only three cause of fire. Timanin niyo niya. Natural cause. So di natural cause. Ikaduha is accidental cause. Ikatulo is intentional cause. So sa natural cause, causes of fire, natural meaning to say that is the beyond control of man. That is out of the control sa human. So naay fire because of the example, the lightning. So, ni nga na. Kilat. So, nagkasunog siya, gumikan sa kilat. So, ni nga na ba? Then, we have also the accidental cause. Wala tuyo ah. Halimbawa na, iskandila na tumba, nagsunog sa bakuran, na gumikan sa kusog sa hangin, na napalit tong mga aso, napalit tong kalayong, mga combustible materials ng mga papel, so na napunta sa silingan, nasunog ang silingan. Okay? Then we have also the kanang mga wiring, so mga short circuit, so accidental na siya. Charger nga nabiyaan sa sulod sa balay, wala ibot, imbuto, so accidental cause na siya. Opposite ana niya is kanang gitawag intentional. Intentional cause, meaning to say, there is really a person wants to burn that building, okay? So, meaning to say, that person intentionally set on fire on that building. So, iyang intentionally gisunog ng building. So, that is intention. Sa three nga kusi sa fire, ang pwede ra mo kaso, ang pwede ra na to ang makasuhanan na is katong ikatulong nga cause, intentional. Accidental, dili ka pwede ka makapailog. Kaso, anak, pero madetermine mo, dihagi ka ng sunuga, dinadamay ang mga balay, dili mo na sa mapailan o criminal liability, but you can after the civil liability. Pabayro ni mo ng balaya nga siya mo hinungdan, nga nung nasunog po kapil yung balay. But it then out po ninyo kung makaya po sa itong balay nga hinungdan, mga nasunog po, na, may source sa sunog sa balay. So, sa tulok akos, only ang pwede tamo pile of charge ng arson is ang intentional cause. Okay? Sa natural, di ka pwede makapile of kaso dia. Sa accidental, di ka pwede makapile of kaso dia. Why man? Because walay gusto nga tao nga sunugon yang balay. Kung siya hainungdan ang sunog sa balay, di gagikan siya kay natumba ang kandila or nainimbuto sa iyahang or na ang inungdan, naka-short circuit iyahang quarantining, that's why nasunog siya. So walay gustong tao na sunugon ang balay, kamahal sa balay. So walay gusto sunugon ang balay. Only yung intentional rata pwede makapile o kaso. So that is the reason why we need to investigate the fire to determine the causes of fire in order to prevent similar occurrence. So if the Bureau of Fire Protection will have the conclusion that most of the time may tabo ni nga sunog gumikan ana, so at least ma-prevent nila for the in the future. The determination of the origin and cause of fire is arrived at only after a thorough investigation. So you can only determine the cause of fire by the investigation itself, by the thorough investigation. What do you mean thorough investigation? Giayo og investigate, that's why mahibalaan nila unsa hinungdan sa sunog. Since basic investigation is prelude to the discovery of the true cause of fire, an understanding of the chemistry of fire and its attendant behavior should be concerned for the successful investigation. Is fire investigation complex and unique? So this is the reason. Why is it that fire investigation is unique and complex? Complex, medyo diligid sa sayon, lisod gud siya. Unique, tungod kay, because you're investigating an evidence nga being destroyed by the fire. So fire destroyed evidence. Tama. Gidestroy sa fire ang evidence. So the evidence is torn to ashes. You cannot collect an evidence physically, but you can collect the ashes. If this arson, it is planned, motivated, and committed discreetly. So it is very challenge for the fire marshal investigator to determine whether that certain incident or certain nga pagka-distract sa building, whether that is an arson or not, i-determine na lang nila na. So dili lalimay mong fire investigator katungod kay i-determine po ni mo kasi causes. Ako, ano siya? Accidental cause ni siya. Sure ka, accidental bagi na siya? Basi, huwag intentional na siya. So lisod kayo mag-investigator ka ni. Kay may i-determine pa ni mo sa causes sa fire. Intentional ba? Natural ba? Or at the same time, accidental ba? At the same time, asa nag-originate ang kalayo? Listen kayo. Rarely can there be an eyewitness in the arson cases. So talagsaon ra kayo na yung makawitness nga kana nga sunog is arson na siya. Okay? Wala gali makatestify nga witness gani nga gisunog nagtuyo, paingon yun na sa accidental ang kusi sa fire. Siman ang ito nyo ha? Walay witness makay makatestify nga kana sa is giintent ginagsunog, paingon na sa accidental ang kusi sa fire. Fire investigation, the totality of the process involving the determination of whether or not a fire occurrence is accidental, incendiary or caused by natural causes, or that is intentional. Okay, so muna siya ha. So ang fire investigation daw, the meaning of fire investigation is that the totality of the process. Why man? Because you are going to investigate thoroughly, involving the indetermination or not a fire occurrence is accidental, incendiary or causes by natural causes. Arson investigation. So that is fire investigation ha. So arson investigation, the art of probing and analyzing an incendiary. Intentional fires, which is unintended to identify, locate, and ultimately prosecute the perpetrator. So muna sa meaning sa arson investigation, the art of probing and analyzing an incendiary or intentional fire which is intended to identify, kisa yung i-identify mo yung suspect, i-locate, imo sa i-trace kung asa na siya nagpuyo, and ultimately prosecute the perpetrator by presenting an evidence during sa imo ang investigation. Muna si arson investigation. When we see arson investigation, there is a person nga set fire on that building. Na-identify siya nga intentional gud ang pagsunog. Pero dili gali ma-determine nga kana siya is intentional na siya nga pagsunog, fire investigation dara na siya paingon. Lahi man ning arson investigation o fire investigation. Ang fire investigation is limited only the accidental o natural ko sa fire. Example, naigo sa liti, nasunog ang balay, gumikan kay nabilin kandila or gumikan sa short circuit sa kurente, fire investigation. But if na-identify nga naay nagsunog anang balaya, intentionally gisunog siya, ang tawag ana niya arson investigation, dili fire investigation. Why man arson, sir? Because there is a person identified who intentionally set that building on fire. Okay? Nasabtan? So, that's the meaning of, unsan mo na yung diferensya sa duha. Arson investigation, the art of proving and analyzing. So, nga naman, ay na-identify nga tao nga nag-set good siya of fire on that building. Intentionally, which is identified, which is intended to identify, locate, and ultimately prosecute the perpetrator to the proper authority by presenting the evidence. Balik ko na ko ha, kung natural cause lang o accidental cause, fire investigation lang itawag na niya. Pero arson investigation gani, na-identify nga tao nga kinanglan i-prove niyo sa korte nga guilty gid siya. Okay? Next question. Okay. Answer is all of the above. Which of the following law punishes the crime of arson? Under sa Presidential Decree No. 1613, muna pinakaunang abalaon sa arson, PD 1744, Revised Penal Code, all of the above na punish sa crime ng arson. Overview of the law on arson. Previously, arson was defined and penalized under the different articles of the Revised Penal Code. Article number 320, nag-define ra ang destructive arson. Article 321, other forms of arson. Article 322, causes of arson not included in the preceding article. So these are the provision under sa Revised Penal Code. Okay? So on March 7, 1979, citing certain inadequacies that impede the successful enforcement and prosecution of arsonists, then President E. Marcos issued Presidential Decree number 1612. So supplanted the penal code provision of on arson. So November 11, 1980, the law on arson was again revisited via Presidential Decree number 1744. The new expanded the definition of destructive arson by way of restating the Article 320 of the Revised Penal Code. The amendatory legislation paved the way of the reimpose of the capital punishment of destructive arson. So there is a Republic Act number 6975, an act to impose death penalty on a certain heinous crime, was passed on December 30, 1993. Article 322 again underwent a revision. So under aning panahon class, kani under aning Republic Act 6975, arson was considered as heinous crime. So therefore, the penalty is death penalty through lethal injection isa if you are committing arson. With the law repeal of the death penalty law on June 24, 2006 through the Republic Act 9346, arson is no longer a capital offense. So because of the Republic Act 9346, muna siya nag-abolish sa death penalty. Because of the Gloria Arroyo nga panahon ni siya nga time class. So ang RA 67659 mo na nagpanis nga ang arson is death penalty na siya kay ma-consider man sa heinous crime. But pag-abot sa RA 9346 mo ni siya nag-abolish sa ani nga balaod kani 67659, that's why wala na tay death penalty karon. Okay, so di na taasaan, di isa taana. Factors involved to be established to complete a fire investigation. So these are the cardinal rules of investigation. The what of investigation, cause that which fire start, what? Then the why of investigation, reason which lead to the cause of a fire or a motive leading to the action. So money siya class. So money factor involved to be established to complete a fire investigation. So what is the cause that which a fire start? So unsa may nahitabo? Okay kana. Then why kana, why mo pinakalisod kay you need to prove if that is a motivated or not motivated nga pagka sunog. Kay kung motivated na, dapat imo na establish ang motive. Anong yang gisunog? Gumikan kay nag-away ang manag sa asawa. Gumikan kay para matabunan ang crime nga yang gibuhat. For example, gipatay niya ng tawhana. So iyang gisunog ang balay pagkahuman. So nganong gituyo man to niya? Amo na gingingon nga tabunan niya ang krimen nga iyang gibuhat tinaagi sa fire. So lugar katong tawhana namatay because of the fire. So mo na nga i-establish ang motive. Pala, Andre. Ito ni discuss tagsa-tagsa. Naram din ni Dre, oh. Okay, classes of fire according to the cause. So, natural or innocent fire, the fire caused naturally without human intervention. Mano yung inyong kanina, natural cause. So, that is beyond the control of man, ganang mga sa liti. Accidental, fire causes where human action is involved directly or indirectly. Kanang gibiyaan niya ang charger nga iyang gi-charge. Ang kandila, wala bantayan, natumba. So, ana ba? So, muna yung mga accidental, nga whether directly or indirectly nga pakaitabo. Arson or intentional nga intentional fire. So, may nang giingon og intentional. Fire cause and result of the willful and criminal action of a person. So, meaning to say, there is what we call intention. Intention nga giintin na siya intin nga sunugon. So diha ma-constitute na to nag arson nga kana nga causes. Anon fire which are not classified as to the cause. Arson. Okay, arson is a crimes against property. Tama. The willful and malicious burning of another's property of the burning of one's own property with intent to injure or defraud insurer of the company. The burning of all kinds of building structures, aircraft, watercraft, crops, forest land, and personal property. So this is arson class. So crimes against property na siya, willful and malicious. Willful meaning to say intentional. Malicious burning of another's property or burning of one's property with intent to injure, defraud the insurer of the property. Pwede po. Kaya example, kana nga building is, karaan na kaya nga building. So, or na-bankrupt na imuhang company. So, para lugar nga, nga, example na bankrupt na imong company class ba din imong ibuhat lang gisunog na imong building. Ganong gisunog man imong building, mas makabawi man ka kay ngano man magbayad man insurance company sa imong building kay naka-insured man ang company. So ana ba? So muna siya that the fire was ignited willfully and maliciously to destroy buildings or property of human origin by incendiary means not natural or accidental. So muna arson na. The burning actually occurred, property need not to be destroyed, scorching is sufficient. Okay, wala tayo gitawag o frustrated arson klasa. Ang arson na to is either consummated or attempted. Okay, that a property is of another or in the case of one's own property that intent was to injure or defraud the insurer. Muna ko ngayon nyo kaganina nga, kung ang purpose nimo is para bayaran ka sa insurance company kay kana imong building is karaan na kaayo or daan na kaayo or na bankrupt ka, so gisunog nimo na imong building, so pwede ka ma-charge og arson ana if mabantayan sa investigator nga gisunog na sag tuyo para lugar imong purpose da is to defraud the insurer, so imong pabayaron lang ang insurance company, so imong gisunog na imong building. Okay, that any person who caused the fire to be set is aided, counseled, or procured the burning is equally responsible as the actual fire setter. Okay, bisan pag dili ka mo'y nagkuha, nanugo lang ka ipasunog na, parehar mo og liability ana. So what constitute arson? Okay, una there is what called burning, nga ginasunog. There must be a burning or scorching or tearing example, the fiber of the wood must be destroyed or decomposed. Its identity or physical state changed.
Isang pagwala pa na nasunog na ni whole nga tibuok nga balay, as long as naalay nag-start nga nasunog diha. Okay?
So, matawag na nato na siya burning. So, pwede na siya matawag na tog arson. Willfulness. The act was done purposely and with intention.
So, meaning to say, ang pagsunog ni mo is intentional, with willful, with your knowledge.
With your knowledge nga that the act you have done is actually is not good, that is bad. So naasay intention nga imong sunugon. The next, motive. The motive is the moving cause that induced the commission of the crime.
Ngano imong sunugon?
Sample, sunugon nimo tungod kay nag-away mo sa imong asawa. Sunugon nimo tungod kay wala nakaganay sa iyong pamuyo. Gisunog nimo tungod kay nimbalos ka sa imong silingan, gisunog nimo iyang balay. So may motive, reason behind nganong imo siyang gisunog.
Malice, it denotes hatred or desire for revenge.
O muna siya kanakay kalagot or nakay pagbalos pinagi sa pagsunog. Kay lahi mong good, sahay mong good kay sample, naglagot ka, niya di man mo mapatay siya, kaya di man ka siya magawasan. So, yung magbuhat, gisunog ni mo iyang balay. Then we have also the intent. So, intent is the purpose or design with which the act is done and involves the will to do the act. So, that is intentless. So, kanain mo ang gibuhat is, that is what called intent. The act you have done, that is intent. So, sample, imong gisunog na. So, that is your intention na. Sunog, gisunog yun mo siya. So, that is the conceit of the crime arson. Okay. Okay, so, that's all muna. Thank you so much for listening.